Hello friends, today we are going to study an apology for poetry. An apology for poetry is one of the monumental works in the history of English literature. This is the first work in English on criticism. Sir Philip Sidney, the Elizabethan poet, wrote this work. An apology for poetry was written in 1580. It was published in 1595. Here Sir Philip Sidney defends poetry against the charges led by Stephen Boson. An apology for poetry highlights various issues such as the definition of the poetry, the concept of poet, the poet's fame in the various countries, types of poems, comparison of poetry with other literary forms such as history and philosophy, etc. An apology for poetry is also known as a defense of poesy. As a first monumental work, it is very important to study it. Let us jump on our topic. MCQs alone, an apology for poetry. Number one, which of the following is true to an apology for poetry? Options are A, it is an essay by Sir Philip Sidney. B, it is Sidney's reaction to Stephen Boson's pamphlet, The School of Odes. C, it is also known as a defense of poetry. D, all these are true. Correct option is D, all these are true. Number two, what is applicable to Sidney's an apology for poetry? Options are A, it is the first English work on literary criticism. B, it was written in 1580. C, it was first published in 1595. D, all of them are applicable. Correct option is D, all of them are applicable. Number three, as Sidney thinks, which of the following is true to poetry? Options are A, poetry is an art of imitation. B, poetry is divine in nature. C, poetry is the oldest of all forms of human learning. D, all these are true. Correct option is D, all these are true. Number four, to Sir Philip Sidney, the function of poetry is dash. Options are A, to teach, B, to delight, C, both to teach and delight, D, none of these. Correct option is C, both to teach and delight. Number 5, Sir Philip Sidney defines poetry as dash. Options are A, an art of imitation, B, an art of versification, C, an art of presentation, D, an art of word selection. Correct option is A, an art of imitation. Number 6, among the Romans, the poets were known as dash. Options are A, makers, B, wax, C, bards, D, rhymers. Correct option is B, wax. Number 7, as Sir Philip Sidney thinks, the brazen nature is turned into golden color by dash. Options are A, historians, B, philosophers, C, astronomers, D, poets. Correct option is D, poets. Number 8, identify from the following the form of poetry cited by Sidney in an apology for poetry. Options are A, religious poetry, B, philosophical poetry, C, imaginative poetry, D, all these. Correct option is D, all these. Number 9, Sir Philip Sidney hails poetry as dash. Options are A, the first light giver to ignorance, B, the nurse that enables to feed the for knowledge, C, the mother of all forms of human learning, D, all of them. Correct option is D, all of them. Number 10, who of the following wrote the fable of the Atlantic Iron? Options are A, Solon, B, Tyrtaeus, C, Pericles, D, Herodotus. Correct option is A, Solon. Number 11, to Sir Philip Sidney, the end of all earthly learning is dash dash. Options are A, virtuous action, B, prosperity, C, fame, D, contentment. Correct option is A, virtuous action. Number 12, who of the following regards poetry as more philosophical and more ingenious than history? Options are A, Plato, B, Aristotle, C, Socrates, D, Herodotus. Correct option is B, Aristotle. Number 13, to Sidney, Dashtas is the greatest gift to mortals next to reason. Options are A, speech, B, imagination, C, humor, D, satisfaction. Correct option is A, speech. Number 14, Sir Philip Sidney calls Dashtas the least liar. Options are A, poets, B, historians, C, philosophers, D, astronomers. Correct option is A, poets. Number 15, he nothing affirmeth and therefore never lieth. The remark made by Sir Philip Sidney is in connection to dash dash. Options are A, poets, B, historians, C, astronomers, D, painters. Correct option is A, poets. Number 16, which of the following is true to the teaching of the philosopher? Options are A, philosophers teach by precepts, B, philosophers teach obscurely, C, philosophers teach them who are already learned, D, all these are true. Correct option is D, all these are true. Number 17, in his work entitled Dashtas, Aristotle admits poetry as more philosophical and more ingenious than history. Options are A, Discourse of Poesy, B, Nicomachean Ethics, C, Poetics, D, Politics. Correct option is A, Discourse of Poesy. Number 18, who of the following regards worship to be inseparable to poetry? Options are A, Scaliger, B, Aristotle, C, Plato, D, Socrates. Correct option is A, Scaliger. Number 19, in his essay, An Apology for Poetry, Sir Philip Sidney attempts to reply dash dash charge against poetry. Options are A, there are many truthful branches of knowledge, B, poetry is the mother of lies, C, poetry is the nurse of abuse, D, Plato banished poets out of his commonwealth, E, all of them. Correct option is E, all of them. Number 20, in England, the poets were known as dashtas in the past. Options are A, makers, B, wags, C, bards, D, worshippers. Correct option is A, makers. Number 21, the end of all earthly teaching is dashtas. Options are A, virtuous action, B, glorious life, C, name and fame, D, none of these. Correct option is A, virtuous action. Number 22, poets teach by dash dash. Options are A, example, B, percepts, C, both percepts and examples, D, none of these. Correct option is C, both worships and examples. Number 23, historians teach by dashes. Options are A, example, B, percept, C, both by example and percept, D, something else. Correct option A, example, B. Number 24, as Sir Philip Sidney says, Quamedy imitates dashes. Options are A, common errors in life, B, actions of lonely minds, C, funny events in life, D, sunny moments in life. Correct option is A, common errors in life. Number 25, as Sir Philip Sidney thinks, tragedy teaches dashes. Options are A, uncertainty of the world, B, to face suffering in life, C, to enjoy glory in death, D, to face adversities. Correct option is A, uncertainty of the world. Number 26, Dashas is the most accomplished kind of poetry. Options are A, heroic poetry or epic, B, lyric, C, elegy, D, comedy. Correct option is A, heroic poetry or epic. Number 27, to Sir Philip Sidney, Dashas human learning is good. Options are A, that teaches, B, that moves to virtue, C, that teaches and moves to virtue, D, that neither teaches nor moves. Correct option is C, that teaches and moves to virtue. Number 28, which of the following is true to Sidney's opinion about Plato? Options are A, he regards him the most worthy of reverence, B, he considers him the most poetical philosopher, C, both are true, D, none is true. Correct option is C, both are true. Number 29, how many cities throw for the citizenship of Homer? Options are A, 2, B, 3, C, 5, D, 7. Correct option is D, 7. Number 30, Plato gives high commendation to poetry in his work entitled Dashas. Options are A, Ion, B, Republic, C, Symposium, D, Alcibiades. Correct option is A, Ion. Number 31, Dashas is known as the Roman Socrates. Options are A, Apollo, B, Plutarch, C, Leodius, D, Seneca. Correct option is C, Leodius. Number 32, Sir Philip Sidney hails England as Dashas in an apology for poetry. Options are A, the mother of excellent mind, B, the land of valiance, C, the mighty fountain of knowledge, D, the land of fine arts. Correct option is A, the mother of excellent mind. Number 33, Sir Philip Sidney speaks warmly about Chaucer's letter. Options are A, Troilus and Cressida, B, the Book of the Duchess, C, the Nun's Priest's Tale, D, the Canterbury Tales. Correct option is A, Troilus and Cressida. Number 34, the lyrics of Dashas have been hailed as worthy of noble mind by Sir Philip Sidney. Options are A, Earl of Surrey, B, Thomas Wyatt, C, Thomas Campion, D, Edmund Spenser. Correct option is A, Earl of Surrey. Number 35, which work of Edmund Spenser has been hailed by Sidney as worth reading? Options are A, Schaeffer's Calendar, B, Fairy Queen, C, Iphithalmium, D, Diophnida. Correct option is A, Schaeffer's Calendar. Number 36, which of the following is true to Sir Philip Sidney's opinion about Barbara? Options are A, it is full of stately speeches. B, it is full of well-sounding phrases. C, it is full of notable morality. D, all these are true. Correct option is D, all these are true. Number 37, Sir Philip Sidney cites Dashkas as an example of the tragic comedy in the ancient time. Options are A, Amphitrite, B, the Golden Age, C, Media, D, Ajax. Correct option is A, Amphitrite. Number 38, Dashkas is the end of poetry. Options are A, delightful teaching, B, exposition and correction of folly, C, contentment to mind, D, something different. Correct option is A, delightful teaching. Number 39, whom Apollo regards the only wise man? Options are A, Socrates, B, Terence, C, Plato, D, Aristotle. Correct option is A, Socrates.